morning students, today we have to see about textbook evaluation. First choose the correct answer. Page number 134 in your book. First question you see, a solution is a dash mixture. They given four options, that is homogeneous. The number of components in a binary solution is 2. Which of the following is universal solvent? Water. A solution in which no more solute can be dissolved in a definite amount of solvent at a given temperature is called saturation, saturated solution. Identify the non-aqueous solution, sulfur in carbon disulfide. When pressure is increased, a constant temperature, the solubility of a gas in a liquid increases. Solubility of NaCl in 100 ml of water is 36 gram. If 25 gram of salt is dissolved in 100 ml of water, how much more salt is required for saturation? 11 gram. Okay, next question, 8th question. A 25% alcohol solution means 25 ml of alcohol in 75 ml of water. That is option C. Next, deliquescence is due to strong affinity to water. Which of the following is hygroscopic in nature? That is silica gel. Okay, next. The component present in lesser amount in a solution is called solute. Example for liquid in solid type of solution is amalgam. A solution is the amount of solute dissolved in 100 gram of solvent. Polar compounds are insoluble in polar solvents. Okay, next. Volume percentage decreases with increasing in temperature because expansion of liquid. Okay, next, mass the following. Blue vitriol, that is copper sulfate dot 5H2O, that is CuSO4 dot 5H2O. Gypsum, that is CaSO4 dot 2H2O. Next, deliquescence, that is sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Hygroscopy, that is calcium oxide. So, mass the following. 2, 4, 1, 3. Okay, next we go to true or false, that is whether it is false, you say the correct statement. Solution which contains three components is called binary solution, not a binary solution. Binary solution contains only two components, so it is false. Write it as false and underline the word binary and write it as ternary. Okay, in a solution, the component which is present in lesser amount is called solvent. Lesser amount is solute, so you underline the solvent and write it as solute. The statement is false. Okay, next, sodium chloride is dissolved in water to form a non-aqueous solution. Sodium chloride dissolved in water, so water is a aqueous solvent, so it forms a aqueous solution. So underline the non-aqueous and write it as aqueous solution. Okay, fourth question. The molecular formula of green vitriol is MgSO4.7H2O, not MgSO4.7H2O, it is FeSO4.7H2O. Okay, next, when silica gel is kept in open, it absorbs moisture from the air because it is hygroscopic in nature. True. Okay, next, short answer. The term solution, that is in page number, page number 125, components of solution. 9.2, first line. A solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances, and down you see solute plus solvent gives solution. The two also you want to write for the first question. Next question, what is the binary solution? Same page, B side you see upwards, a solution must at least being consist of two components, such as solution which made up of one solute and one solvent are called binary solution. Okay, next, give an example for each. That is page number 126, table 9.1, they having a example also. See here, gas in liquid, soda water, that is carbon dioxide dissolved in water. Next question, solid in liquid. See here, solid in liquid, sodium chloride dissolved in water. Next, solid in solid, that are copper dissolved in gold alloy.
Next, gas in gas, that is mixture of helium oxygen gases. You have to write these examples for these questions. Okay, next, what is aqueous and non-aqueous solution? The same page 126, 9.3.2, second paragraph, aqueous solution having that first two lines and non-aqueous solution B having that first three lines. The solution in which any liquid other than water acts as a solvent is called non-aqueous solution. Next, aqueous solution example, the same second paragraph, last two lines, and the third paragraph, last three lines, that is the example for fourth question. Next, define volume percentage, that is page number 129. Volume percentage is given 9.5.2. Volume percentage is defined as that three lines and two formulas. You must write for this question. Okay, next, aquatic animals live more in cold region. Why? See here, page number 128, 9.4.1, B side, solubility of gas in liquid heading, effect of temperature. You see solubility of gas in liquid, that is second paragraph. Aquatic animals lives more in cold region because more amount of dissolved oxygen is present in water of cold regions. This shows the solubility of oxygen in water is more at low temperature. Okay, next question you see. Define hydrated salt, page number 130. Hydrated salts and water of crystallization. 9.6, first paragraph, last four lines. The number of water molecules found in the crystals substance is called water of crystallization. Such salts are called hydrated salts. This one you want to write. Next, a hot saturated solution of copper sulfate forms crystal as it cools. Why? You write down, on cooling it absorbs water molecule to form a copper sulfate pentahydride. So it forms a solid substance. Okay, next, classify the following substance into deliliquescence and hygroscopies. Sulfuric acid, copper sulfate pentahydride, silica gel, these are hygroscopic. Calcium chloride and gypsum salts are deliliquescence. Okay, long answer. Saturated solution and unsaturated solution. See here, page number 126, 9.3.3. Based on amount of solute, there is saturated solution heading having that paragraph, and again goes to 127 page number, unsaturated solution heading having these two. You combine and write, you get the answer for this question. Okay, next, you go to write a note on factors affecting the solubility, page number 128. Factors affecting the solubility, that is 9.4.1, fully up to effect of pressure, that page fully. Okay, next, we go to the next question. What happens when magnesium sulfate heptahydrate, that is page number 130, 9.6.2, fully without diagram. Okay, next, in what way define solubility, second question, that is third la A question I given. Next, B question, define solubility, page number 128, A side, top corner, you see solubility is defined as the number of grams of solute that can be dissolved in 100 gram of solvent to form a saturated solution at a given temperature and pressure. So you have to write that one, and down you see solubility is equal to mass of solute divided by mass of solvent into 100. That formula also you want to write for solubility question. Next, you go to, in what way hygroscopic substance differ from the deliliquescence. See here, page number 131, difference between hygroscopic substance and the deliliquescence, that is table 9.3 fully. Okay, next, sum, 5th sum and 6th sum already we written in the note the day before yesterday. I give your sums that you copy in the note, I think. Okay, next hard question you see. Hard question for second question. First question we written already written. Second question you see. No need. That hard question, three questions also I give you in the PDF form or page number. You copy it in your sum note. Okay, students, thank you. This lesson is over.